miniature Legette-Jack is an iconic figure with the university community in Western New York. She is an accomplished athlete, an outstanding coach, a trusted mentor, and an inspiring role model. It is with great pride and great pleasure that I am honored to introduce our commencement speaker, Coach Felisha Legette-Jack.
I remember my son, he came here from Indiana, In comes this kid, bursting in the door and saying, "Macy O'Jack, my name is Sterling, and I'm with the basketball team, and you're going to be my teammate." And it just made his day, and it made his life. And you may have that experience. And if you don't have a Sterling to come do that for you, just knowing your inner ear, God sits with you. I'm already proud of what you have become. I already see your future. It's so bright. It's already hurt my eyes. But know that the stumbling blocks are there for you to become something that's going to propel you to something bigger. And don't forget about each other. You guys went through so much together for the last 2 years or 3 years. How many years have these young people been together since? Some of you, 9 years. And as you go through your different schools, it's so easy to try to get locked into where you are. Don't forget your friends. Don't forget where you've come from. Don't forget your story. Don't forget your dreams. Don't let somebody say, "Oh, come hang out with us and you know, put your dreams over here." And then you become, because it's easy. Choose the harder for your dreams. And pick that phone up. Now, I know you're not going to pick it up. You always got your hand. Probably got it on your graduation. Text each other. Stay in touch. I'm still friends with my 11th middle school classmates and my high school classmates. Just before I came here, I was on the phone with my college teammates. And we just continue to grow. We just continue to evolve. And you are great at the now. But don't forget where you've come from. I'm just excited to be here. This is not about me. Not about my path. I walk with my head down to the 10th grade. Basketball gave me the ability to look people in their eyes. Find what it's going to be for you to look in people's eyes and let them know that you matter. And let them know that you have enough courage inside your spirit to see their eyes and see their dreams. And tell your story. It may not be a lot of people. No one really cared that I played basketball when I was in the 9th or 10th grade. 11th grade, and all of a sudden in 12th grade, 300 schools said that was pretty good, and everybody wanted to be a part of my story. But remember the small circle that you have right now, that believe in that silly dream that you have. That's going to be the reason why you buy your mom and dad a house. My mom retired making $36,000. And I had that little dream to go to college and play basketball and one day be able to afford an opportunity to take care of my mother. And people laughed. I kept my head down. I kept tending to my dream. And now here I am, the head coach at the University of Buffalo. I'm making a few dollars so I can take care of my mother. I think you're listening now to that silly dream. So as silly as you think your dream may be, don't lose it. Keep it in your back pocket. Keep talking to man upstairs, your God. And keep reminding him that you're not going to give up on your dreams. And ask him to not allow you to do that. Proud of you today. We'll be proud of you tomorrow. These people that's behind you, it's just your village that's going to support you. But the most important person on your journey to your success is yourself. We can't do it for you. There's no magic box that we're going to open and make you become the CEO, the COO of your corporation. You got to do the work. I think from the foundation you have for the last 8, 9 years at the school that you're in, you have the foundation. You got to do the work. Go take your dreams with you and don't ever relinquish them for anybody. God bless you. And God's will.
So I was told to put a quote to base my speech on, and to be honest, you take a couple minutes. The first poem that I'll go is from Maya Angelou, a famous author. She once said, "If you don't like something, change it. If you can't change it, change your attitude." I think that this quote applies to the students of the 8th grade class and what is happening at our graduation in many different ways. Ladies and gentlemen, this is such a huge step forward, but not necessarily just because of what we leave behind or what we consider our everyday normal and our concerns. It's because of what we're entering and what is being handed to us. This is the start of real independence. This isn't like being allowed to be home alone at night for the first time, or getting your first home even. For the first time ever, we are being given real opportunities. Opportunities to run our own lives and to change the lives of others. I think that we can all agree that there's a lot that needs changing. Things that need to be done, and even some things that need to be reversed. Things that need to be said to. Every place and every age needs those that will step up and do those things in their own styles and ways. I believe that the real significance of graduation is that for the first time we are realizing that starting next year, this is the perfect time for us to start doing so. Still, it would be foolish to say that graduation is important to us just because of what it means to our futures. It's also because of the fact that it's a connection of our past and our futures. From our elementary and middle school years to high school and college years. We're probably beginning in our midst of adulthood and childhood in the next 4 years. Too young to be concerned with adults, but nobody is going to just give things to us on silver platters anymore either. I've been told, and I've heard, and I've seen, many people say that the best years of their education, their lives, or their college years. I don't know if I agree after all. I've never been to college yet, have I? But I have also heard the same thing about the high school years. Next year will be more challenging than the years we have experienced so far, but in the end, it's really your own self that makes a difference in the world, not how many degrees you have or what grades you get. Albert Einstein said, "Education is what remains after one is forgotten what one has learned in school." Now many people will mention this. The thing that really matters the most for school is to hopefully learn skills that can be used for life, like interacting with others and having experiences from which to grow and learn. Let's be honest, we're not going to remember most of the math you learned in school, or how to write a book, essay, or the entire history of America and the world. Not many people do. The thing that you should aim for is to discover where your talents and passions truly lie. And then learn how to use them in a way that you enjoy and that makes an impact on the world. Maybe you don't want to speak out or wait or to be in the spotlight or to become famous or anything like that. That's okay. There is a point in life where you need to stop doing things just because it gets you a good grade or puts you on your teacher's good side or gets you rewarded by your parents. There's a point in your life where you need to do things for yourself, for your own reasons, because you actually want to. And then while you are doing so, you can find how you can do what you love and while still affecting others in good ways. Lewis Cavalier said, "Change is the end result of all true learning." By the end of next year, and even more so by the end of the next 4 years, you will not be the same person you were when you graduated this year. That's okay, because if you came out of debt the same, it would mean you didn't learn. No matter how many facts you memorize, or passes you pass. Change is almost always for the good. It is my hope that each and every one of us will make our changes good ones. No, great ones, and better ourselves along the way too. You always say that you have a word at your fingertips. Up till now, it hasn't been exactly true. Still, you made it all the way to the end of 8th grade, which is no easy feat. Starting right now, I can confidently say that I believe for the first time ever, we really and truly have a goal at our fingertips.
Felisha, back to you, Morris. So on behalf of the school,